Thank you for inviting us. Good evening, everybody. I will be really, very short, I promise you. So, the clinical case of one of our patients who addressed to our clinic. This is a young lady. She was born in 1982, and she complained of severe bone pain, practically all the bones of her body, that first occurred during pregnancy. At the moment of her staying in our clinic, she was breastfeeding and she had a baby, and her baby was 9 months old. She was tested for vitamin D concentration, and the result was 12 nanograms per mil. It was February. And at the time she was prescribed cholecalciferol, 2 drops, it's approximately 1,000 international units daily. Repeated measurements of vitamin D showed the results of 21 nanograms per mil, and as at this time the patient had already stopped lactations, the dose was increased up to 2,000 international units per day. So approximately in 2 or 3 weeks, the repeated testing was performed, which showed that vitamin D concentration increased, and there were no any changes in showings of markers of motor neuron or markers of calcium and phosphorus metabolism. The patient, we performed the DEXA for this young lady, and we showed that the T-score and Z-score at L1 at lumbar spine was minus 2.5, but what happened to our patient during this therapy, after this period of therapy, that she reported that her pain syndrome completely resolved. Another case, and unfortunately this patient that I'm talking about, she was lost to follow up, and we couldn't proceed her further history. But I would like to share with you another clinical case, which was reported by our colleagues. This case concerned a young woman, 35 years old, who was also complaining of back pain of growing intensity. First, she felt this pain in the last trimester of the first pregnancy. She was 22 years old at the time. And this type of pain was classified as non-specific low back pain, and no further diagnostic evaluations was performed in this patient, fortunately. The patient was breastfeeding for the next 3 months after first pregnancy, and in 2001 she had second pregnancy, and at the end of the third trimester of this pregnancy, she sustained a great intensity of pain in the thoracic and lumbar spine. Neurological examination didn't reveal any changes. And due to the severity of the pain syndrome, the pregnancy ended in cesarean section. The patient was hospitalized. Among other findings, there was noted that the patient lost 3 centimeters in height in comparing with the stature before the first pregnancy. The patient didn't had any chronic diseases and didn't take any medication that could affect her bone metabolism. She didn't take any calcium supplementations during pregnancy, and she was smoking before the first pregnancy. So, instrumental examination revealed compression fractures. Laboratory tests didn't reveal any abnormalities, And DEXA was performed, which showed that T-score at lumbar spine were -3.3, and at BMD at hip was -2.09. So the diagnosis of osteoporosis complicated by multiple vertebral fractures was performed. The patient was treated with calcium and vitamin D supplementation, bisphosphonates, and after 2 years of treatment, shavings of DEXA of bone mineral density improved, as you can see on this slide, and Z-score was -1.77. So, BMD and CREDMETS, now we don't have any specific data. All the data are controversial. And most studies which are published are up to date, they evaluated BMD after delivery. Some authors have demonstrated that at this period, lumbar spine BMD decreased by 4.5%. And some other authors revealed that osteopenia were observed at least at one skeletal site in approximately half of the woman who recently delivered. And only a few studies available that compare BMD before and after pregnancy, and they also show the decreasing of BMD, and the variation of this decreasing is rather high. So we should keep in mind, though this situation is rare, but still we should keep in mind and evaluate the risk factors of osteoporosis and osteoporotic fractures in pregnancy, because as a rheumatologist, I often deal with young patients who suffer from rheumatoid arthritis, systemic lupus erythematosus, and some other autoimmune disorders that could be the reason for secondary osteoporosis. So, most common risk factors that can lead to osteoporosis in pregnancy is idiopathic osteoporosis, big bone mass, inherited diseases of musculoskeletal system, secondary osteoporosis due to many reasons. It was discussed earlier today. And other factors that are not well established yet. So we can conclude that osteoporosis is a rare, osteoporosis during pregnancy is rare, but severe type of premenopausal osteoporosis, and we should pay attention to the most often symptoms, acute back pain due to vertebral fracture, and this pain usually occurs during the third trimester of pregnancy or in early postpartum period. Exact mechanism and risk factors of this condition are not evaluated yet, as well as there are no published systematic analysis, but we shouldn't underestimate this serious complication in young women with pregnancy and underlying risk factors for low bone mineral density. Thank you.
We have got some time left for questions and maybe for discussion. Your question, please, or your opinion about this case.
Okay, thank you very much.